Black Zack back with another video series based on the online game Star Wars The Old Republic. This is the class story for the Jedi Consular. While the Jedi Knight is the better hero story, I think the Jedi Consular is the better Jedi story. Let me know your thoughts about the story in the comments. Enjoy the video. Black Zack out.
If you detect the aroma of Alderaanian nectar,
I've heard a report from Nar Shaddaa. The Guiding Hand has disbanded, and the Hutt cartel has withdrawn its vendetta. Your handling of the cartel was extremely impressive. Diplomatic skill under pressure is a rare gift. Now perhaps Duras Fane can be rehabilitated.
Master Fane seems quite set in his ways.
True. He has changed little since he was a Padawan. I am glad your mission on Nar Shaddaa was a success, but now I have an urgent matter that requires your attention. We received a distress signal from the Republic starship Corrida, and we suspect it's plague-related.
Is there a Jedi Master on board?
No, not a Master. A Jedi passenger. She has lost her mind and killed several people. Of particular interest, the Jedi in question is Lorana Fane, Master Duras Fane's daughter. Fane is on his way back to Tython, but I've asked him to join us over Holo. I thought he should be kept informed.
I should hope so, Sile. Being a Jedi doesn't stop me from caring about my own daughter.
I may gain insight into this plague from Lorana.
Any discovery about Vivekar or how the plague is spread could be vital. You will dock in the ship's forward section, where Lieutenant Bella Wynn and her men have managed to find safety. Find Lorana Fane. Shield her if you can and see what you can learn. Go with care.
Hold your fire, men! Hold your fire! It's the Jedi the Council sent. Sorry, Jedi. We're all a little on edge.
Are you doing all right?
We're pretty shook up, but at least we're alive. No thanks to Lorana.
She was a great passenger at first. Happy, smart, interested in the ship. But then we were hit by an Imperial ambush.
Lorana fought them off, almost died from her wounds.
After a day or so, she started talking strange and then slaughter.
If she was so badly injured, why couldn't you stop her?
It didn't go like that.
After the ambush, we put out a call for medical assistance, and a Jedi Master answered. He healed her right up. He was odd, though. Had these horrible scars he kept covering. Never said his name. You know, Lorana was different after he left.
It's possible he wasn't a Jedi at all.
But he healed her. The girl's as strong as a Rancor. It was a struggle, but we managed to trap her in the aft section. If I can just...
Lieutenant Wynn, Lorana's slicing into the Corrida systems. She's taking over the whole ship. She'll start shutting down life support soon.
No! Jedi, please! You're the only one who stands a chance of stopping her! Do whatever you have to. Just don't let Lorana kill any more of my men!
A child could do this.
Thank you. I'll release the lockdown for a moment to let you in, but I won't risk Lorana getting out. There's a comm device back there. Contact me when you've taken care of her, and I'll release the lockdown again so you can leave. Good luck.
Thank you. What if we hear? A little engineer poking around where he shouldn't? I wonder what this button does. Was that the airlock? Silly me. Bye-bye, little engineer.
It's time you answered for your crimes, Lorana Fane.
My crimes? You're so silly. The ship is nearly under my control. Isn't it wonderful? The darkness is coming, but it won't take me.
Lord Vivekar has taken control of your mind. You must resist.
Lord Vivekar? The nice man who healed me? He warned me about you. But you're not going to kill me, Jedi. I won't let you.
I won't let the darkness take me. Go away or I'll open the airlock. I'd rather die than be taken.
You don't want to release the airlock. You want to come to me.
I want to come to you. I won't release the airlock. Take my lightsaber. Please don't let me hurt anyone else.
This won't take long.
What did you do? You look so weak. But Lord Vivekar's voice is gone. The voice in my head. How did you do it?
A shielding ritual that blocks Vivekar's influence. The same ritual that saved your father.
But it's taken a lot out of you. And the difference for me, it's like night and day. I just can't believe I let that monster make me do those terrible things. I'm sorry. I'm going to lock myself in the brig until we reach a port. I don't trust myself.
Lorana, my child, my apprentice, Jedi. So, you have robbed me of a most promising student. As if that will delay the inevitable. You Jedi are an endless source of amusement.
Is that why you created this plague? For your amusement?
For power. I was once a Jedi like yourself. A mindless drone to the Order's precious code. There is no emotion, only peace. I believed, but the teachings of the Dark Lord Terek Morridge showed me the error of my ways. Thousands of years ago, Morridge's hatred nearly crushed the Jedi. That is true power.
The hunger for increasing power becomes an endless spiral.
Is that why you persist in using that worthless shielding technique? You know how the originator of that technique died, don't you?
He sacrificed too much of himself and perished nameless. Everyone I have ever touched could fall to this plague. You cannot shield them all.
What if I use my shielding technique on you?
My power is already beyond your comprehension, and every moment makes me stronger. You are too late. I've already won.
Restored Lorana Fade to the light. She's in the brig and won't cause any harm.
Are you sure, Jedi? I mean, she killed a lot of my people.
I know. She will face justice for it. Don't worry.
I trust you. You saved our lives, and if Lorana's in the brig, she should be secure there. I'll report back to Master Sio immediately. You should do the same. Once we get the ship back under control, we'll set a course for Coruscant. Thank you for everything, Jedi.
I've just received Bellowin's report. I'm so glad Lorana Fane is shielded and well.
Thank you for my daughter's life. I have to go to her.
Did you manage to learn anything more about Lord Vivekar, the Plague Master?
He claimed that he was once a member of our order.
I'm listening. So this scarred man who healed Lorana Fane is Lord Vivekar. Amazing work, Jedi. Still no leads on how to find him, but we do know more about his plague.
What happens now?
I wish I had better news, but the situation has worsened. Two more Jedi Masters have now gone silent. In their last transmissions, both Masters said, "The darkness is coming." One Master was on Alderaan, the second on Tatooine. You must go to these worlds and investigate, quickly.
I will do everything in my power to help.
Thank you. I know you will. May the Force be with you on Tatooine and Alderaan. Good luck. Jedi, the Council sees you've arrived on Tatooine. Good. We can't waste any time. Tatooine is a vast desert world where survival is often precarious. Master Eris Vassen, one of the Jedi's best cultural explorers, was there when he dropped out of contact with the Council.
Has he exhibited any symptoms of the plague?
No, but he was a member of the expedition to Malachor III, as were Master Yuan and the others. Cultures must perform a delicate balancing act to even survive on Tatooine. Master Eris came to Tatooine to study that balancing act. If this illness has claimed him, it would be a great loss to the Jedi Order and threaten the groups he was sent to study.
Then I guess I'd better get to work.
Eris hired a guide to help him navigate Tatooine's treacherous deep desert and make contact with its residents. One of Master Eris' last reports was that his guide had developed the sand rot, an illness caused by prolonged repeated desert exposure. The guide's name is Rowan Delk, and he is currently recuperating at the Dreviat Outpost Medical Center. He's your best lead.
Consider it done.
Work quickly. Master Eris is vital to the Order. And if he has this plague, well, you, more than any of us, know what that means.
Tyrants, damn tyrants, the lot of you. Treating a grown man like he's a baby. Like he can't take care of himself.
For a man who's supposed to be ill, he certainly is vociferous, which is to say, loud.
Lie down, Delk, and quit roaring. I swear, a Ranko with heartburn would make less noise than you.
I'll make as much noise as I want. Hey, Jedi! You a friend of Master Eris? Get Darth Nurse here off my back, will you?
She doesn't look Sith to me, but I did want to talk to you about Master Eris.
You two can talk, but don't let him fool you into letting him walk, Jedi. He's got the sand rot, and bad.
That man breathes in a little sand, and after 20 years guiding folks through the desert, he suddenly can't make decisions for himself. What's it you wanted to know about Master Eris?
We believe Master Eris is very ill.
I'm listening. Jedi plague? I'm begging your pardon, but I don't believe it. Sure, maybe some masters, but not Master Eris. He's the brightest, most level-headed guy I ever met.
We've seen this illness twist even the most level-headed Jedi Master.
Look, you want to talk to him? You're welcome to it, but I'm telling you, he's just as sane as you or me. When I left him, he was in the desert with them annoying little Jawas. I really impressed him how they managed to survive out there.
Do you know what Master Eris was doing with the Jawas?
Studying them? Far as I can tell. Trying to understand their crazy little culture, now. They're friendly folk, the Jawas. Even if they don't understand the meaning of the words private property, if Master Eris isn't still with them, I'm sure they'll help you find them.
If you didn't want trouble, you shouldn't have attacked me. I must know where he went. Give me this message. I'd like to help any way I can. I believe this is what you wanted. I am quite honored.
Jedi, would you look at this? They let me walk around the clinic. Soon they might let me cross the street by myself. Any luck finding Master Eris?
Will you take a look at this holo recording?
What's this? A message from Master Eris? I know this encryption. Shouldn't take long to crack. There. Care to see what he has to say?
Rowan, you've realized by now that I've left those most resourceful of creatures, the Jawas, in pursuit of greater things. I came to Tatooine to discover the secret to life. Not its creation, but its ongoing survival. How do some species thrive while others fail? A great darkness is coming, Rowan, and to withstand it, we must know the answer to that question.
That phrase is familiar. Has Master Eris spoken of this darkness before?
Well, not to me, but there's more here. Maybe he explains it.
I believe that the Jawas, whose enduring civilization thrives in spite of Tatooine's harsh conditions, would answer that question.
Their technological prowess is quite the achievement, though their ability pales in comparison to my own. I wonder why he abandoned them.
But during my daily meditation beneath the pillars, I saw a vision on the cave wall that showed me the error of my assumptions. I now know the true original people of Tatooine, the warriors whose knowledge I will use to stem the coming darkness.
Every master afflicted with this illness has mentioned the coming darkness.
Aren't you Jedi always fighting the dark side, or whatever you call it? It seems perfectly sane to me. Master Eris used to take lights out to a cave near the rock pillars at night and meditate. Sounds like that's when he had his vision. Well, you're a Jedi. Maybe you could do the same thing.
It's the best lead I have.
You can use my old dragon flares as lights. The cave gets pretty dark. Just be careful out there. Rumor is the sand people are getting riled up. Don't let them catch you with your lightsaber sheathed.
Jedi! Did it work? Did you see Master Eris' vision?
There was no vision, just a lousy wall carving.
A carving? Now, Master Eris never mentioned a carving on those walls. What did it show?
The Sand People conquered everyone on Tatooine.
I'm listening. The Sand People are the oldest group on Tatooine? Doesn't say much for progress. Still, I bet none of them get the sand rot. I have a hard time believing Master Eris would do anything so cockeyed as working with the Sand People. At least the Jawas are good for droid repair.
He said it himself. He saw the vision on the wall and went to find the ultimate warriors.
Wait. What did you say the symptoms of this thing were? Delusions? Paranoia? What, violence? One group of Sand People has been unusually aggressive lately. Normally, they stick pretty close to their camps. I'm not saying I think Master Eris is behind it, but maybe it's worth looking into.
Now you're starting to use your brain.
I can only go by what I've seen of the man. I'm sorry. There's a farming settlement out at Malcolm's Dunes that's been reporting a lot of Sand People activity. I'll meet you out there. I know some of those folks, and I can help your investigation.
I appreciate the help, but I'm sure I can do without it.
People in the desert don't take well to strangers, and if Master Eris is stirring the Sand People up, they won't like a Jedi one bit. Besides, it'll do me good. Don't care if it kills me. I'm tired of being an invalid.
Heard of us. Isn't your day? That's quite enough of that.
Like some sort of massacre. Holiday, don't look!
Listen, Delk, we got broken vaporators, a pile of wounded, and our food stores are almost completely gone.
That lunatic said he was a Jedi and a friend of yours. We trusted him.
You better have a pretty good explanation for why this Master Ares keeps sending sand people out to attack us.
That's the Jedi I'm looking for. Where is he?
Another Jedi? Damn it, Delk. Why do you keep leading them here?
Listen here. We've already lost too much to that Master What's-His-Face and his army of sand people.
So why don't you just leave here, quiet-like, and don't cause any more trouble?
I will leave when I find Master Ares.
Why should we tell you a thing?
I'm sorry, Jedi, but our trust is a bit worse for the wear at this point.
Well, Master Ares was nice enough when he came through asking to study the sand people.
But ever since we pointed him to their camp, you could set your chrono by their attacks. We got nothing left.
I promise you, Master Ares will answer for his crimes. But you must tell me where this camp is.
What? And let you help him with his plan to destroy us? I don't think so.
I promise I am not working with Master Ares.
All right. I guess we don't have a choice. I'll draw you out a map. In fact, some of our guys scoped out a side entrance you might be interested in. It's a little less crowded, which could be all the difference. There's something weird about these sand people. They seem faster and stronger than normal.
Well, I think I know where that is. I'll get some gear together and meet you out there, maybe provide backup.
I can take care of myself.
Even so, I'd like to see Master Ares for myself. Still can't believe the Master Ares I worked with is the same guy who's causing so much trouble.
Now us. Let's settle this. Weakness.
quite enough of that.
About to witness it. After weeks of work, finally, an end to the darkness. These people, these marvelous, marvelous specimens have been tested, no, purified, in the crucible of Tatooine's harsh environs. They alone are the hope of the galaxy. Their strength, their society, is the blueprint of our salvation.
These are savages, Master Eris, and they're murdering innocent people.
No, not savages at all. They are simple, but long after the Empire and the Republic are gone, these people will remain. Their culture is built around strength. They cut the weak away like a societal cancer. Don't you see? It's the only way.
Lord Vivekar has his fangs in you deep.
How can I make you understand? They are the ultimate warriors purified by hardship. We must follow their example and cut away everything that would make us weak in the face of our adversaries. The frail, the diseased.
You're not thinking straight now. Look, I'm sick, Eris. You gonna cast me out too?
I have no choice. We must fortify the Republic with its strongest members and send this army of light out against the darkness.
An army of light that neglects the weak is no longer light.
You fools! To oppose me is to reveal your own weakness. You will be cast out.
Really, you haven't heard of us.
Wait. Before you strike the killing blow, listen to me.
I hear Lord Vivica's voice. I've failed him, just as I failed my old friend Parcanus when he died.
Why does everyone mention Parcanus?
I don't know, but I keep thinking about our first mission, our ill-fated mission to Malachor III. We were all weak. We all came under the thrall of the dark side. We did things we regretted, but Parcanus was our strength. As we tried to escape, I fell behind, and he ran back to save me. He became trapped. We had to leave him. It was my weakness that killed him.
Parcanus knew the risk he was taking.
Yet I can't shake the feeling that his spirit hates me for it. It is why I have thrown myself into this project. Think about it. The Jedi Order spends so much time protecting the helpless and caring for the sick when we could be fighting the Empire. You must kill me. I was weak on Malachor III, and I'm weak now. But you must take my findings before the Council. Promise me that.
Let's see how you feel once Lord Vivekar no longer has a hold on you.
What was that? He's gone. Somehow you've driven Lord Vivekar away. I no longer hear his voice. I almost I almost wish you hadn't done that.
Of all the ungrateful, impudent... This Jedi saved your life.
Lord Vivacor twisted my mind, and I'm glad to be free of him. Still, my discovery remains. From these sand people, I have learned the key to building the unstoppable army. I feel I must bring these findings to the Republic. Yet, I can't shake this feeling that some truths are best left buried in the sand.
Losing this information would mean the sacrifice of every good the Republic stands for.
You're right. These records are no more. Thank you for your guidance and for saving me from Vivekar's grasp.
Jedi, I'm glad Master Eris is alive and his own self. Best get back to Anchorhead myself. Sand Rot's acting up and, well, frankly, sort of miss Darth Nurse's hollering.
Watch yourself while I'm gone.
Yeah, I've gotten by okay this far. Good luck with whatever it is you're doing, Jedi. Hope you find this Lord Vivacar.
Master Eris has reported back to the Council. Good work. He speaks of discoveries on Tatooine. We intend to hear his full report when he returns to Coruscant. Did you discover anything more about the Plague Master, this Lord Vivacar?
Master Eris seemed to think Vivacar was why he kept remembering Malachor III and his friend Parcanis.
A connection between the events on Malachor III and our current circumstances is clearly forming. The Council will continue its own investigation into the matter. Meanwhile, hurry to Alderaan. So long as Lord Vivacar has control of even one master, he will grow in power.
I won't let you down.
Good. Do not delay. Every wasted moment works in Lord Vivacar's favor. Jedi, the Council is pleased to see you've arrived on Alderaan. Until recently, Alderaan was a part of the Republic. Today, it's on the brink of collapse. Shortly after seceding, both the Queen and the heir to the Alderaanian throne were assassinated. A usurper, Boris Ulgo, stepped into power, setting off a civil war.
I assume one of the Jedi Masters is here.
Master Sidoni Garen, one of the Jedi Order's finest strategists and diplomats, dropped out of contact briefly while on Alderaan. She's made contact since, but was evasive about her silence. Master Sidoni is brokering a peace on Alderaan. If she is suffering from the plague, it could jeopardize the entire peace process.
I won't let that happen.
Master Sidoni was working with the head of House Organa's diplomatic corps, Hala Morgana. Find Master Sidoni and make sure she is well, that the peace process is not in jeopardy.
Welcome, Jedi. I'm Hala Morgana, head of House Organa's diplomatic corps, and this is my younger, more handsome brother, Lou.
Please, Hala, you do yourself an injustice. Your age gives you a stately difference.
If I wasn't wearing my extra years around my waist, I might agree. Now, Jedi, how can I help you?
I'm looking for Master Sidoni Garen. I believe she may be ill.
She seemed fine last I spoke with her. Well, you just missed her. She's at the Peace Summit. A Peace Summit on Alderaan. Imagine that. But I'll call her. The location of the summit is a secret for obvious reasons. But I'm sure she'd welcome your assistance.
Hala Morgana, I'm sorry, but I'm very busy right now. The summit is just getting underway.
I was hoping I could join you.
You're Master Yuan's student, aren't you? It's wonderful the Council sent you to assist me, but this is a very delicate process with no place for a Padawan.
I passed my trials, and I think the Council knows what it's doing.
Only official representatives of the Houses may attend the summit. What would the other Houses think if another Jedi from House Organa showed up? And I don't have time to debate, if you'll excuse me.
Master Sidoni, I'm sorry, Jedi. That's really not like her.
All the more reason why I need to get into that summit.
Yes, well, Master Sidoni said that only representatives can go. Unfortunately, Organa's representative is already there.
Hal, House Tyrol, you know, with the beautiful daughter. Couldn't our Jedi friend represent them?
Huh, my brother is a genius. House Tyrol is desperate for a representative, but the usurper Ulgo destroyed their hopes. If you could help them defend themselves against their enemies and return them to glory, I'm sure they'd make you their delegate.
Tell me where I need to go.
You'll find Lord Tyrol in his house's last holdings, an enclave near Ulgo lands and Killik nests. I will let them know you're coming.
And beware the Killiks. Those insect men have terrible tempers.
Agua buntacho, chubalong haku, ya sa un kubas, taja bakta tun bunko.
Have you been hurt?
Kuse je sinchi, di nomano kava je ulwani. Wanta humpa, muri rava fupa je bampa wula. A king sali ki kava dumpa stupa.
I will destroy them all.
A king sali ki kava dumpa stupa.
Are you Lord Tyrol? I'm here to become your delegate to the Peace Summit.
Jedi, yes. Organa told me you'd be coming, but, well, this is... well, it's complicated. The whole house needs to approve a new delegate, and, well, they say they won't approve a stranger.
He may be a stranger, but he's a Jedi. I should think you'd be grateful for his assistance.
Yes, of course, but House Tyrell has fallen so hard, we don't even have the strength to hope. It will take more than my word to convince them.
From now until the summit's end, I will live, sleep, eat, and breathe House Tyrell's interests.
Really? Well, all right then. After our original delegate was murdered and Ulgo drove us back into this hole, I'd almost given up hope myself.
Just tell the Jedi our plan, Father.
Right. House Tyrell's current position is precarious. Our enemy, House Ulgo, seeks our destruction. Their army is at our gate. House Tyrell needs a strong ally if we are to survive. We need Haas Organa.
What would be involved?
We proposed a marriage alliance to House Organa. My daughter Fasha would marry Lu Organa.
But House Tyrell is weak, and powers within Organa. Fear we'd drag them down with us.
We need to prove to Organa that House Tyrell can defend itself against its enemies.
If you can defend yourself, do you really need an alliance?
We only need to defend ourselves for a short time to win the confidence of our prospective allies. As I've said, House Ulgo's forces are at our gates, threatening to drive us out of our last holding. But Ulgo's commanding general, Astar Vox, is a mercenary with a loose definition of loyalty. If we can reach him, turn him, we can break the siege.
This approach seems overly complicated. Can I use my lightsaber instead?
Killing him would break the siege, but my hope is that Astar Vox can help House Tyrell build up its armies. If he won't be bought, by all means kill him. But if you can bring him to our side, House Tyrell's security will be the better for it.
I'll see what I can do.
We have no time to waste. I will contact House Organa the moment I hear that the siege is broken.
I've come representing House Tyrell. They want you to give up this siege and join them.
Well, isn't this a surprise? The Jedi have decided to involve themselves in Alderaanian politics. You must be pretty sure of yourself to walk into a room of highly trained commandos. But you should know that I don't do business with just anyone.
I am a Jedi. My word is good, as is House Tyrell's.
I'm sure it is, but that's not my concern. The battlefield is the only true test of a person's worth. War, bloodshed, these are the fires and forges of greatness. I only negotiate with my equals. Besides, my men are itching for sport. Best a pack of my warhounds, and we'll talk.
The Force will strengthen me.
Excellent. I've not had the pleasure of seeing a Jedi in action. Release the dogs!
Just as I programmed. Quite enough of that.
What do you think, boys? That was a little too easy, wasn't it?
Aye. Let's see a real challenge.
Easy? I take exception. You're trying to kill us.
What do you mean, too easy?
Those dogs were old, weren't they, boys? You need to do better than defeat a pack of geriatric mutts. No, you need a real challenge. What'll it be, boys?
Droids! Droids! Droids!
Droids it is, then. These are the best Ulgo has. Beat them, and we'll talk.
They'll fall just as easily as the dogs.
Droids! Activate attack protocols. Target Jedi.
Maybe you haven't heard of us. That's quite enough of that.
Excellent, excellent. I like your form, Jedi. But I'm not entirely convinced yet. Sure, you can beat a couple of dumb machines, but what about Ulgo's finest warriors? Smart, fast, highly trained, and hardened by battle.
You mendacious vagrant! Twice now you've broken your promise.
On my honor, this is the last time. Beat my champions, and we'll talk.
I've got plenty more where that came from.
Boys, you heard the Jedi. He's spoiling for a fight. Show him a good one.
That's quite enough of that.
Impressive Jedi. I didn't think House Tyrell had the resources left to recruit such a powerful ally. No hard feelings. If you knew how many fools come by offering me jobs.
Everyone needs to be tested every now and again.
Exactly. What makes us strong? Let me guess. House Tyrell would like me to stand down the army that's at their gates and perhaps join them?
No, they'd like you to put on a dress and do a jig. Of course they want you to join them.
Well, no need to get impatient. You can tell House Tyrell that my answer is yes. It's been fun working for House Ulgo, but there's no glory in working for the biggest army on the planet. I'll call off my troops and meet with Lord Tyrell immediately. Don't worry, I know the way.
Jedi, thank goodness I've reached you. There's good news and bad news. The good news is everyone's heard how you impressed Astor Vox and broke the siege, including Organa. They've agreed to the marriage alliance. Now the bad news. Lu Organa has been kidnapped.
Who is Lu Organa again?
Hallam Organa's younger brother. His marriage to my daughter Fasha was to be the linchpin of the whole alliance. This is clearly Ulgo's doing. The kidnappers were from their ally, House Rist. An Organa-Tyrell alliance would be disastrous to Ulgo. They must have ordered Rist to kidnap Lu Organa to stop the alliance.
Surely Organa has planned a reprisal.
House Organa is preparing to attack House Ulgo. And if they do, casualties will be great and peace impossible. The entire peace summit will collapse, and with it, our hopes for an alliance. But if you're able to rescue Lu Organa on House Tyrell's behalf, we can still prevent a battle and secure our alliance.
Those assassins will be no match for a Jedi.
Use caution, Jedi. Rist's assassins are uncanny, and you'll be going right into their nest. Be careful, but hurry. We need to beat the Organa attack, or everything falls apart.
That's quite enough of that.
Ah!
Jedi!
Thank goodness. I thought they were going to kill me. House Tyrall sent you, didn't they? They called about an alliance. I was riding to meet them and... Well, thank goodness you're here.
I'm glad I was able to make it in time.
Thank you. I'm still a little sore, but I'll live thanks to you. I was going to meet with House Tyrall to discuss the marriage alliance when these assassins swooped in and knocked me off my Thranta. I woke up here. But were they trying to prevent the alliance? Who would want to do that?
Without the marriage alliance, I can't get to the summit. Maybe someone doesn't want me to go.
Who would care if you went to the summit? Though now that you mention it, as I lost consciousness, they were talking about Master Sidoni. But how could she be involved? It has to be a frame job. It must be.
I believe Master Sidoni is very ill, but if I can get to the summit, I hope to help her.
I just want to trust Master Sidoni. I'm sorry. My head. I still get these pains from the fall. I can't leave here until I know if Master Sidoni was involved. The kidnappers used to go into the other room to contact their employer. I'm sure we'll find a comm device there. We just need to see who they've been calling.
Really, you haven't heard of us? That's quite enough of that. Some exercise.
I can't. Oh, Jedi, I appreciate your desire to help, and I will be sure to praise your zeal to Master Yuan. But I am extremely busy right now. I can't afford interruptions.
You hired the assassins who kidnapped Lu Organa. Why?
I would be careful about making such outrageous accusations against a Jedi Master. Now, if you'll excuse me, Jedi, I have very important work to do.
Wait, Master Sidoni! I don't understand. What was her frequency doing here?
How much more proof do you need? That's why I need to get to the summit.
But if that's true, then the summit, delegates from all of Alderaan's houses, she could be planning something terrible. Please, I need to get out of this place. My head is killing me, and I keep looking over my shoulder expecting more assassins. I'll see that the Organa-Tyrall alliance is finalized, and that you get to the summit.
I don't understand. Why would you want to risk it?
Lord Tyrall, without risk, there can be no glory. The only way to avoid risk is to avoid war. But that's not very effective or fun, is it?
No, I suppose it isn't. Ah, Jedi, welcome back. General Vox and I were just discussing strategy. We haven't stood this proud since our house was young and building its first alliance with House Pantyr. Thank you, Jedi.
It was your plan. I merely executed.
But we couldn't have done any of it without you. Lu Organa and my daughter Fasha are getting acquainted as we speak. I spoke with the rest of House Tyrall, and the decision was unanimous. You are our new delegate. Congratulations!
So, how do I get to the summit?
Well, that's something I'm not entirely clear on. I have the packet the last delegate was supposed to use, but I don't understand its contents. Some coordinates and a data spike. It appears that you need to go to those coordinates and do something with the data spike?
I just hope she's not planning any tricks.
Just one moment, Jedi, if I may. We would like to ask one last thing. There will never be peace for House Tyrall as long as House Ulgo exists. If you're able to use your influence as a Jedi to convince the summit to strip House Ulgo, ensure they never hold a title again, we'd show our gratitude.
I don't want to do anything that will destabilize the peace.
Please, Jedi. House Tyrall has security now, but we still require justice. Good luck at the summit. I hope you find Master Sidoni well, and that all goes smoothly.
Manchi Doti Puna Puna Kabuk Nunis Nemo.
I have Master Sidoni's permission.
Kabanotase Makipuna Malituta Udmishka.
So here it is, laid bare before you, the irrefutable evidence. House Ald has been conspiring against House Organa for years, preying on their good trust. House Thule is the reason the Pantir heir was assassinated, and House Ulgo is merely a puppet of House Rist.
Lies! All lies!
There are holographic recordings, documents. You can't argue with hard evidence.
We trusted you! How dare you! You will meet our armies on the field of battle!
Master Sidoni, what have you done?
You wouldn't understand. I do this for the good of the galaxy.
This is not the way.
I am a strategist, Jedi, first and foremost. I live by variables and outcomes. I have calculated the future, and for the galaxy to have peace, there must be war on Alderaan. I will not be shaken from this course.
I'm sorry, Master Sidoni, but I can't let that happen.
You are too late. All the pieces are already in place.
You're a fouler liar than House Rist.
House Rist takes exception to that characterization. Murderer?
That was 30 years ago.
We had an alliance!
House Organa has heard enough. It's clear to us that there can be no other course but war.
If you go to war now, the deceptions and murders will never end. It's best to put an end to the fighting now.
Listen, everyone! If we go to war now, the deceptions and murders will never end.
We need to put an end to the fighting now.
You're right. It'll never end.
We can't go to war now.
Thank you, Jedi. You've shown us our error.
What have you done?
I did what was best for Alderaan.
And doomed the rest of the galaxy in the process. The darkness is coming, Jedi. War must rage on Alderaan for 50 years, and only then can we put an end to the darkness. But you haven't won yet. Once you're out of the way, I'll make them see.
I tried to keep the darkness from coming, but I failed.
Be calm. I'm here to help you.
It's too late to help me. I failed, Parcanis. It's my fault Parcanis died. Malachor III. I miscalculated. He had to be left behind. He died because of me. Vinikar, my head. Please, I can't block out his voice any longer. You must kill me to silence him.
I won't kill you. But you don't need to hear his voice again either.
Jedi? What? How did you... I don't understand. My mind is clear again. And you're... weak. Will you be all right? What did you do?
It's a shielding ritual. It should keep Lord Vivekar's voice out of your head for a while.
Thank you, Jedi. I only hope the sacrifice wasn't too great. For a while, I thought I was able to block Lord Vivekar's voice from my mind. If you hadn't been there with your calm sense, I don't know what would have happened.
I saw what Lord Vivekar was able to do to Master Yuan. I'm not surprised he was able to twist your thoughts as well.
You are most understanding, Jedi. I will contact the Jedi Council. I'm sure they'll want a full explanation.
I think I can safely speak for all present when I say that the summit applauds your efforts.
Indeed. But I have to say, Jedi, I'm at a loss as to how to proceed from here.
Let there be a truce, and let the summit reconvene at a later date to work on a formal peace agreement.
The summit will reconvene at a later date to discuss the details of a peace agreement. Thank you again, Jedi.
Jedi, I hear the summit has agreed to continue peace talks.
Thankfully, the delegates saw reason.
Thankfully indeed. We all owe a debt of thanks to you and Master Sidoni. My only regret is there's no talk of removing House Ulgo's noble status and lands once the war's over.
You should just be thankful peace is even possible.
I didn't mean to criticize. I'm grateful for all you've done. I just can't feel safe as long as Ulgo commands an army. But what am I saying? House Tyrell is far safer now with peace in view and Organa as an ally than we ever were. And I have you to thank.
I must be going now.
You've done House Tyrell an invaluable service. I hope you will come visit us again. Master Sidoni just checked in. She seems well, but very frustrated with herself. She reports that you were able to prevent war from breaking out on Alderaan, however. You've once again done very good work in a tense situation, Jedi.
I relied on the teachings of the Jedi.
A mark of a true Jedi, being able to trust in the Force in all circumstances. Tell me, did you learn anything new about the Plague Master, Lord Vivekar?
She told me he was in her head, influencing her actions.
I see. Master Sidoni was the last of the Lost Masters, and yet Vivekar still eludes us. Return to us here on Tython immediately, and we will discuss what you have learned. Lord Vivekar cannot remain hidden forever.
You summoned me, Master Seo.
Welcome home.
I wish we could greet you with better news.
Despite using every avenue available to us, we are no closer to finding Lord Vivekar.
Actually, I believe we are. A common thread binds all the plague victims. The loss of Parcanis Tark at Malachor III. Vivekar's influence forced the sick masters to relive their failures on Malachor. This is revenge. Personal revenge. Only one man would have that much anger and pain. The man who was left behind. I believe Lord Vivekar is Parcanis Tark.
Jedi, Parcanis is dead.
Far from it, Jarek.
Yuan? I told those Padawans to keep an eye on you. You must rest.
No, my pupil, my fellow Jedi, deserves to hear the truth about Malachor.
Then tell us, Master Yuan.
Malachor III isn't just strong in the dark side. The planet is the resting place of the Sith Lord Terak Morage. Our work on Malachor woke Morage's spirit. One by one, we fell under his power. The things we did still haunt me.
Somehow, you got free of Morage's power.
Yes. Together we managed to break his control, but at a terrible cost. Harkannis was the youngest and weakest. We had to abandon him to Malachor's darkness. His sacrifice allowed the rest of us to escape, but it seems he survived and has taken Morage's dark path.
You knew Vivekar when he was Parkanis Tark. How can I stop him?
I must make amends. I have a plan to help you find Vivekar. If the plague created a link between my mind and his, your shielding ability may allow me to use that link to find him.
No. You're already weak from the plague, Yuan. This could kill you.
Vivekar won't get the chance. I'll be between him and my master.
It's our best chance to find Vivekar.
Rather intrepid, isn't she? It's quite fetching.
Very well, Yuan. But we will monitor the ritual, and your former Padawan must stay at your side.
Thank you, Sio. I will go to the meditation chamber to prepare. Please meet me there when you're ready. Thank you for coming. I have made all the preparations for the ritual to find Lord Vivekar. I plan to create a connection between us, using your shielding ability. If it was Parcanus, this should work. Drawing on your strength, I will invert the link between myself and Vivekar, and use it to sense his location.
This ritual sounds dangerous for both of us.
There are risks. For one, the shielding you gave me on Coruscant will be severed. I don't know what will happen then. It's possible I could die once your shield is gone.
You must resist, Master Yuan. Don't give Vivekar another victory.
With your strength to sustain me, we will do what we can. No matter what happens, you must give me as much time as possible. Reversing the link may be a long process. Let us begin. Yes, yes, it's working. I can feel his mind, and I can feel...
She can feel the power that she's challenging. There is no hope. Jedi, you don't look as strong as you did last time we spoke. Yuan has drained your strength and made herself vulnerable to me. Still arrogant and reckless.
I can take anything you throw at me, Vivekar.
Perhaps a little test is in order. See how Yuan's will crumbles before mine. Fitting that two of my enemies will destroy each other.
Allow us. I need some exercise.
It worked. Listen. Lord Vivekar, he's out in deep space on some sort of vessel. Here, take the coordinates. He surrounded himself with defenses. Send this. It's his code. It will give you time to get aboard. No. The darkness. Vivekar's will is too strong. I can't hold on. Please, kill me. End it now.
I won't let that darkness touch you.
Ah, the darkness. It's gone. But you look exhausted. You have sacrificed so much for me.
Hopefully, Vivekar should no longer be able to influence you.
Your shielding ability has driven him from my mind. Thank you. I must rest. Please, go to Master Sio and the Council. They should hear of what we've learned.
The ritual was a success. Lord Vivekar is out in uncharted space, but he knows I'm coming.
Now only your shielding talent can stop him.
You've shown great fortitude and saved your master despite the odds. But Lord Vivekar will have made preparations, and he still has his greatest weapon, the plague.
With his location revealed, Vivekar may choose to simply unleash the plague on us.
If that happens, your shielding ability will be our only protection. You must survive. Go to the coordinates quickly, before Vivekar strikes back. And Jedi, may the Force be with you.
Foolish enough to come aboard, Jedi. But I can sense your presence.
Did the docking starship clue you in as well?
You are blinded by the light side. You can't understand what you face. Come to me, Jedi. I'll show you how light can be snuffed out.
Indulge me first. Tell me how it felt to fail miserably.
I cannot fail. In fact, I've already won.
Really? Because I'm almost positive I'm still alive.
If you need me to remind you of that, honey, just ask.
You will understand soon, if you live that long.
Power and tactics have got you this far, Jedi, but no further. This battle was decided before you stepped aboard.
I'm tired of your delusions. Explain yourself.
My plague isn't just a disease. It siphons power from its victims. With the proper rituals, that power can be channeled. Soon, the combined strength of your masters will make me the most powerful Force adept who has ever lived.
If you love the Force so much, prepare to become one with it.
You can't defeat me, Jedi. This face, this Vivica, he is just another skin to be shed. Parcanus offered himself to me on Malachor III to crush the Order that destroyed us. He embodied my spirit.
I am no lost Jedi, no ordinary Sith Lord. I am Terak Morage.
Help me stop this monster, Parcanus, or you'll just be another of his victims.
No one can oppose me. I am beyond flesh, beyond death.
I will crush you, Jedi, and your shattered body will fuel my rebirth!
Clearly you haven't heard of us.
Impressive, Jedi. You might even have triumphed, but my victory is already complete. My plague has spread farther than you can imagine. Jedi Masters across the galaxy are succumbing to it as I speak. The plague binds these Masters to me. Hundreds of them. The heart and soul of your Order.
I don't care about your plague anymore. It's over for you.
Ah, yes. Strike now. Kill me, and you will kill every master I have ever infected. Everyone. Shielded or not, they are still bound to me. But what choice do you have? You cannot let me live, and I am deathless. Your shielding talent cannot harm me. You've lost.
No matter what, Parcanus will be freed from you, Morage.
I'm still alive. You spared me.
I have to admit, I'm a little puzzled on that score myself.
My mind is clearer now. But it was your duty to kill me and destroy Morage.
Too many Jedi have been lost already, including Parcanus Tarkk.
Yes, Parcanus was lost. But perhaps he deserves another chance. I cannot return to the Order. But Tython has its hidden places. Its forests. I could find peace there. I could go home. But first, Jedi, listen. Take this warning in exchange for my life. You can't trust the Order or the Republic. You may be their hero now. But they will abandon you too. Remember that.
We felt it. A massive shift in the Force. The masters you saved have reported a sudden improvement in their condition. The plague is over, thanks to you. And I sense Parcanis Tark for the first time in many years. How can that be?
When he comes back to Tython, he can answer all your questions.
We persuaded the Republic to divert a starship to your location, just in case. The crew can bring Vivekar back to us. Thank you for all you have done. The Jedi Order owes its survival to you. Please, return to us on Tython. We wish to thank you in person, and we have a special reward for you.
We've been awaiting your return. Please, step forward.
You have saved untold lives through your defeat of Lord Vivekar and the destruction of the plague.
There's a title reserved for the most prestigious among us, whose wisdom and skill safeguard the galaxy. It hasn't been bestowed in thousands of years.
But you have proved worthy. Now, the Council names you Barsan Thor, Warden of the Order.
I will do all I can to live up to this honor.
I never imagined your potential would take you so far.
And not a moment too soon. We have need of you.
We have received word that the Republic is facing a new threat.
I've yet to face anything I can't overcome.
We need time to prepare a war council. The Supreme Chancellor himself will be attending.
Take time to rest. And you should record your journey in the Jedi Archives. History must know of your actions. Return to us when you feel ready. For now, the entire Order will know there is a new Barsan Thor among us.
Nothing like a well-deserved reward, eh, Jedi? It's no luxury cruise to Corellia, but still. That's quite the title you have.
I feel like I should curtsy.
Don't hold back on my account, Holiday.
In this outfit? You wish.
Well, without Vivekar's minions hounding us, the galaxy is vast and wide. Shall we?
Word of your amazing success has preceded you. Well done. But events are moving faster than we anticipated. The Council is calling an emergency conference with the Supreme Chancellor, and we need you to attend.
Surely the Jedi Council and the Chancellor can manage without me.
We need your unique skills. The conference is being held on Tython, at the temple. Come as soon as you can. There is also another matter we should talk of in person.
They need to talk? Trust me, Jedi, nothing good ever follows those words.
They've certainly piqued my interest.
Yanor Foyna, Zadimo, Ragorant, Rakulud Lexisknas.
I'd hope not. But if such illustrious personages demand our presence, I suppose we shouldn't keep them waiting.
The Supreme Chancellor! This is so exciting! And no time to recompile my hair!
Thank you. Supreme Chancellor, allow me to present the only living Barcenthor of the Jedi Order.
The Council has told me of your exploits. Remarkable. You may be exactly the person I need.
I take it you're seeking my services.
Yes, but I also need your discretion. You may not be aware that the Empire is not our only concern. The Republic itself is on the brink of collapse. Across the galaxy, many worlds are talking about secession. Even open rebellion against the Republic.
This is no time for internal squabbling. We should be united against the Empire.
A small league of powerful planets and individuals has emerged, calling themselves the Rift Alliance.
This Rift Alliance claims to have lost all faith in the Republic. Those worlds are threatening to sever all ties, permanently.
But the Republic is badly weakened. The Rift Alliance controls critical resources, armies, trade centers. If they leave, the Republic will die.
I refuse to believe there's no solution to this.
I want to assign a Jedi as my representative to the Rift Alliance. To prove the Republic takes their grievances seriously, this Jedi will be tasked with solving any problems the Rift Alliance may have to restore its faith in the Republic's strength. When I asked the Council for candidates, yours was the first name they suggested.
I am flattered, sir, but I'm no politician.
You've experienced many cultures and overcome immense challenges. You're the person I want.
Which brings us to the other matter I mentioned. We would, naturally, not assign anyone less than a Jedi Master to such a task.
But your patience, your compassion, and wisdom show that you merit the rank. Will you accept and become the Order's newest Jedi Master?
How could I refuse such an honor?
Kneel, and the Supreme Chancellor will bear witness.
We are one voice, one order, bound together by the Force.
Through his actions, this Jedi has proved worthy. Before our Order and the Force itself.
We grant you the rank of Jedi Master. Protect and guide the Republic as the Force guides you.
Rise, and may the Force be with you.
Congratulations. It is a pleasure to welcome you as a fellow Master.
How should I begin?
I've convinced several diplomats from the Rift Alliance to be guests aboard a Republic flagship, the Fortitude. Rendezvous with the Fortitude and meet with them. Quickly. You are now my best hope to keep the Republic in one piece.
You know these people, sir. I would appreciate any suggestions you can offer.
Get on Representative Alani's good side. Though between us, I'm not certain she has one. And thank you. Perhaps the Republic will have a future. After all.
Hello? You're the Jedi they were sending, yes? I can't talk any louder. Someone right here. Nadia Grell. My father and the other senators. We were all invited here by the Chancellor. Then the ship was attacked, boarded by people calling themselves Sith.
Nadia, make sure no one can find you before we talk anymore.
I'm in an air vent on the command deck. Far from the bridge. The one in charge is called Eryx. He just cut his way through the crew. Then he ordered all the senators onto the bridge and locked it. My father's in there, but I can't get to him. I just hid.
If I can reach them, I can protect the senators and your father.
There's a console on one of the lower decks that can open the bridge. Here, I'll send you the location. Please hurry. I saw the Sith tampering with the engines. We might not have a lot of time.
Yeah.
Caution. Navigational computer illegally locked. Fail-safe systems have been disabled. Collision with Duralia's surface is imminent. Recommend immediate course change to avoid casualties.
Oh, wonderful. My genius is about to be snuffed out thanks to some Imperial grunt's ham-handed sabotage.
Get away from him. I'm warning you. I won't let you hurt him.
Nadia, don't.
You'll just end up shooting yourself, girl. Drop it, or your father and your Jedi friend here will die very, very slowly.
Why have you done this? These people are no threat to you.
Hardly a challenge, either. But I know better than to question my orders. Your ambassadors will die, and this ship will be destroyed. Pitiful, like slaughtering Nexu cubs. But Lord Kyrus demands that your Rift Alliance suffer and fall.
Tell me where to find Lord Kyrus. You don't need to be his slave.
Slave? I do Lord Kyrus's will. He grants me more freedom than any brainwashed Jedi. My lord might find the girl an appealing prize of war once she's incapacitated. But the others must die. It is commanded. And you, Jedi, are in my way.
Just as I programmed.
Nadia, don't you ever! What were you thinking? He might have killed you.
I'm sorry, Father. I couldn't just hide while you were in danger.
Charming, really.
You will talk later, Nadia. The planet's looking dreadfully close, and I saw that Sith lock the navigational computer.
Is there any way to override the Sith's commands or shut off the engines?
The crew knew how, but the Sith, they're all gone.
That Sith also destroyed the life support and fire control systems, so I hope you have another ship for us to evacuate onto.
Please! I don't want to die!
Shush, Blasis. Jedi, could we overload one of the engines to change course? We'd likely hit Duralia's moon instead, but there'd be time to escape, just.
I don't want to risk crashing on top of innocent people.
No, the moon is totally lifeless. I'd never suggest it otherwise.
Wait! We can't do that! If we crash the ship into the moon, it'll...
Tekalia Srek Grula Boska.
I want to hear what she has to say. Go ahead, Nadia.
If the Fortitude crashes into Duralia's moon, it'll change the planet's tides. Whole cities might flood. But the Fortitude's thrusters still work. If we work together, maybe we could steer the ship into orbit instead. You need to take everyone to the controls right away. But we could save Duralia and the moon. And the ship could be salvaged.
Without the computer, we could still hit Duralia.
I can monitor our course from here.
Which Jedi? Time's short. Either we steer the ship, or you'll need to crash it into the moon.
We'll each man one of the thrusters and get the Fortitude to safety.
I'll stay here and guide everyone. Even I can miss a planet.
It's all right, Dorne. Everyone, stay close to the Jedi until you find a console. Quick now!
Now, just as I programmed. You haven't heard of us. That's quite enough of that.
Thank you.
did it! The Fortitude's in a safe orbit over Duralia. Everyone's okay. We're all heading back to your starship. I'll meet you there.
Looks like we're safe, but what happens now?
As I understand it, we've been given a Jedi Master to address our every need, right?
Every need may be a little strong. I'm here to secure your place in the Republic.
Excellent, excellent. Shall I introduce everyone first?
Representative Alani, who can introduce herself.
This is Diab Duin. He represents a planet rich in lightsaber crystals, you call them?
Hello. Ty Corden, Trade Secretary for Balmora. You're the Barsanthur, the Warden of the Jedi Order, right?
Yes. I didn't know my rank was common knowledge in the Republic.
Next is Shuru. He's from a water planet called,
Punchimo. Ubanchone Alipa Isti Patoga.
I'm Blazes. If you need any help from... Well, not that you need... Hello?
And I'm Senator Toba Skrell. My daughter and I are from Sarkai. We've only just joined the Republic.
But we were invited to join this Rift Alliance almost right away. Wasn't that nice?
We certainly don't lack for diversity.
Ah, the Republic. Good at words, but nothing else. If you're really here to help us, prove it. What about Ty? His world's under Imperial occupation, and the Republic's utterly failed to liberate them. Twice.
Alani, there were good reasons for the Republic to pull out. Even I see that. Although, if you did help to free Balmora, Jedi, you'd certainly prove the Republic isn't a failure.
No simple task, even for a Jedi.
True, but I've had years to plan. Technically, Balmora's not a Republic world, just a Republic ally. But the Empire didn't care. Since the occupation, Balmora's government has been in exile, myself included. And our droid factories are under Imperial control. But if Balmora is liberated, I'll see we join the Republic and bring our droid armies with us.
The Republic would be honored to have you.
The Republic actually helping Balmora? That would be... a start.
If Balmora's people are suffering under the Empire, we shouldn't waste time.
Fuipanyaga, Twipi, Taiboka Dunka Wona Wanga.
Yes, that sounds like a good idea.
On a Jedi ship? I never dreamed I'd... I can't wait to see everything.
Balmora. Home. I never wanted to see it like this. I am... was Balmora's trade secretary. I was off-world when the Imperial occupation began. And my colleagues were exiled or killed. Our president, he was taken, and who knows what he suffered. Hiding or not, I now have seniority. If we free Balmora, I become president.
The Empire must know that you're next in line. You're lucky to be alive.
Several Republic worlds protected me. I owe them everything. And once our government is restored, I want Balmora to join the Republic.
Restoring the government will be no easy matter.
I have a plan. It's a little... unconventional.
Ty! It's madness. You don't have any supporters or soldiers, anything.
That will change. Meanwhile, I have a contact who can help us. A revolutionary calling himself Zenith. Zenith and his followers have been sabotaging the Empire's operations. Assassinations, sneak attacks. He's something of a blunt instrument.
How does Zenith fit into your plans?
I need his knowledge and resources, but first, we have to find him. When you're on the surface, go to this location and enter the phrase, "Two perspectives are aligned," into the computer there. It'll get Zenith's attention. Hopefully, he'll be amenable.
You'd be surprised how persuasive I can be.
Best of luck. I've been waiting to return for so long.
I heard that two perspectives are aligned.
Ah. Zenith only speaks in private, and the Empire is always watching. There are privacy scramblers throughout this area, relics from a freer time. Switch them on, and you will be contacted.
That's quite enough of that. Just as I broke it. That's quite enough of that.
Zenith speaking, what do you want?
I came to help you liberate Balmora.
The Republic says that a lot. Then it leaves.
I want to run the Imperials off Balmora, so Ty Gordon's new government can take over.
Unlikely. The old government's in exile. The Empire's too powerful. Ty Gordon was talented. Naive, though. Still, exile can change a person. No. The Republic has failed us before. Help me first, then we'll talk.
I'll expect you to hold up your end of the deal.
Expect what you like. I'm tracking the Imperial head of manufacture, responsible for building weapons and enslaving my people. He's operating from inside the Okara droid factory. Normally, no problem. But he has a powerful bodyguard. I can't get close. Go to the factory and keep the bodyguard out of the way for me? Then we talk politics.
A child could do this.
Don't take long. This mission is vital.
What a sourpuss.
Not everyone has your gracious disposition, dear Holiday. We'd better do his little chore.
First those terrorists, now a Jedi. Saras, handle this intruder.
As you command. Get back, Jedi. I'm apprentice to Darth Lacris, Vice President of Balmora, and this man is under my protection.
You know this isn't the life you should be leading.
Don't try to confuse me. My path is clear. My family has always lived here, watching Republic interference hold Balmora back. But Darth Lacris can lead us to glory.
The Empire has enslaved families across Balmora. Did Darth Lacris spare yours?
Serving the Empire is a privilege. I am proud they have the chance.
You're young and strong. Defy Darth Lacris and help the people you love.
Saras, stop listening to this garbage and kill him!
No. I need time to think on this. I will stand aside for you, Jedi. Find another way to help my people.
You'll pay for that, Jedi! Your drivel just cost Darth Lacris an apprentice, and I'll be blamed! Whatever you came for, I'll never...
What the... Jedi, are you all right?
Bleeding is moderate, but you need treatment at once.
Jedi, good work distracting the bodyguard. Allow me to find a position.
Missed my shot. Step back, please. I need him dead.
His life means nothing to me.
No! Please! I'm not a...
Excellent. Thank you. I found a safe house where Ty and his colleagues can gather. My people are smuggling in there now.
This is it. I'll go on ahead. I hear Ty's plan.
Excellent work. Two of my colleagues have already returned from exile, and we can work safely here.
Plotting to give Balmora to the Republic. One occupation replaced by another. We both want the Empire gone. Our goal is the same. For now.
Without our strategy, you're just a radical throwing bombs and writing slogans.
Whatever works. What's Ty's alternative?
Balmora's strength is in the huge corporations here. They have money, political pull, and military droids. So far, the Empire has left the corporations alone in return for donations of weapons and credits.
Those weapons and funds would greatly improve our own position.
After you both handled that Imperial official, I called my old corporate contacts here. We have their attention. Their resources are invaluable to building our new government. I want their commitment.
What would be involved?
Director Fenn is head of Troida, and speaks for the other companies. He's asked to discuss a deal with us. There's an old records vault outside Sobrak he's chosen for the meet. I'd like you to convince him to help.
I'm sure I can make this Director Fenn see reason.
The Empire watches everyone important. Fenn will have Imperial droids escorting him. For protection. Destroy them quickly or they'll report you to the Empire. Then it's over.
Watch out for the droids.
Clearly you haven't heard of us.
That's quite enough of that.
I see Ty Corden picks his negotiators well. That should wipe your presence from the droid's memory. Director Fenn, Troida. I've been considering Ty Corden's offer. Given that we risk Darth Lacris's anger if we are caught, we want a special favor.
I wasn't informed you would be making demands of me.
Ty isn't aware of this. The Jedi have sometimes opposed our more unconventional weapons. Your ethics cost us credits.
The anguish of the scientist, burdened with petty... I mean, always vigilant against evil.
If we support Ty, I want to promise that the Jedi won't interfere with our weapons development.
Such matters must be decided by the Jedi Council.
But you speak for your council, don't you? Wait, that's... the Imperial soldier monitoring those droids. Stay here. I'll tell him something.
Thought he'd never leave. I have information for you.
What have you learned?
Seems Director Fenn has a wife and daughter in Sobrak. My men know where to find them. Mention that, and Fenn will agree to anything.
I will take it under advisement.
You're welcome. Better go.
There. The Empire suspects nothing. So, can you promise the Jedi will not interfere with our work?
How about instead we send just a few Jedi overseers? It would please the Council, and be good for your image.
Yes. In fact, that could boost our sales considerably. Here. A small token of our goodwill. Now, when the Empire invaded, we hid stockpiles of arms, secret blueprints, credit accounts. They're now yours. And Ty's.
How can I find these stockpiles?
This password will let you access terminals in Sobrak to get data on the stockpiles, but that data is encrypted. Once you have all the data, take it to the sunken Sarlacc Cantina in Sobrak. A cyborg there, Banks, can decrypt and transmit it for you. Just treat him gently. Thank you, Jedi. Defying Darth Lacris has been quite the adventure.
head.
Are you Banks? I need you to decrypt and transmit some data.
You're risking your neck in here, Jedi. Sobek's Imperial now. Everywhere. Even in my head. I'd love to help you, but Darth Lacris discovered how fast I work, and bang, I'm working for her.
Help me, and I'll protect you from Darth Lacris.
You can't stay here forever, Jedi. Darth Lacris has my brain busy processing a data stream right now. If I stop to decrypt this, it's the shock prod.
Your mind is already trained and powerful. You can see how to do both at once.
I can see it. It's so easy. Two streams at once. I can do anything in here. Quick, give me your data. There. Decrypted, sent, and Darth Lacris is none the wiser.
And thus you prove that changing his mind isn't always a metaphor.
We've been receiving the stockpile data. It's better than I hoped. Look, Director Fenn already sent droids for protection. Oh, and Master Seal Bacarn wanted to speak to you.
Yes. I hear you negotiated with the corporations, allowing us to supervise their weapons research. An admirable effort. But I wonder if a few Jedi overseers can restrain them.
This way, the corporations are supervised, but we keep their goodwill.
I see you've thought carefully on this. I trust your judgment. I have Core World's business to attend to. Go well.
With the corporation's support, we're secure enough to begin the next stage of my plan. Word is, our current president, Galtha, is ill. He's rarely seen, and Darth Lacris says she's acting on his behalf. But I need him. Unless President Galtha publicly signs over power to me, becoming president will be difficult.
If he's already in office, why don't we just get rid of Darth Lacris?
If Galtha is still fit for the position, we'd welcome him. But after so long...
Trouble. Informant and Sobrig just recorded this speech from Darth Lacris.
Via our dear President, after these rumors of a new anarchist government, we are pursuing Executive Order 228. Using it, we've unmasked dozens of resistance accomplices hiding amongst us. But rest assured, they are already at our holding facility. Once they're punished for their crimes, Balmora's future will be bright again.
Darth Lacris enjoys rounding up innocents. Set a trap for a Jedi. Kill the prisoners if no one takes the bait. Win-win for her.
Your people should have risen up against Darth Lacris long ago.
Some tried. We call them martyrs. She'll expect one Jedi, but I have allies in hiding. We'll draw the Imperials out, you get the civilians. Plausible?
Tell me where I need to go. Thank you, both of you. We'll start arrangements to send those people into hiding.
I know this holding facility, Death Trap. Here's the location. My men and I will go on ahead. Don't forget what we're risking for you, Ty. Because I won't.
We got the Imperial forces to follow us. A few are being stubborn.
They're guarding the facility and civilians inside put up defenses. Force fields are blocking the entrance.
Have your people search for some way to breach those force fields.
Amateur search. I have plans with the locations of the generators powering those force fields. Shut those down. The facility's open.
Back to work. Be careful.
Cut down on your Jedi. won't let Darth Lacris win.
We placed all our concussion charges around the facility. Shockwave will kill everyone inside.
Timer's already counting down. Get everyone out now.
How can you risk all these people for this vendetta of yours?
Life under Darth Lacris isn't worth living.
I'll pull out, find the civilians you freed. Get the others and head to this outpost.
If I'm not there, report to Ty. Terminal's safe. Who needs to know?
Just as I programmed. That's quite enough of that. Let's end this.
Jedi, you're alive! We've been getting reports of explosions near the holding facility. This line seems secure. First, are all the civilians safe?
We saved the people inside, but Zenith's last communication said he was being overwhelmed.
I was afraid of this. I hope he's safe. Someone's coming.
You should guard your back better, Jedi. You might end up like my people.
You have my sympathies.
Almora will never forget those who died to free her, I swear.
At least the civilians, real Balmorans, are safe. And we got information.
I was in that place, Jedi. If you're looking for President Galtha, I know where they got him.
Is he a captive, or Darth Lacris's accomplice?
I don't know, sir. I just saw him being smuggled in and out of the Balmoran arms factory by the Imperials.
This knowledge could save Balmora.
I hope so. We just want our lives back.
Darth Lacris isn't stupid. She'll guess Galtha's location is out. If I were her, I'd move him right away. If the President vanishes, we'll have a long, slow slog ahead of us. Jedi, I need you to get him out of the factory.
I'm going with you. Darth Lacris has lived too long.
I don't want you involved. You're dangerous and irresponsible.
I'll be good. Plus, you need me. Only I know the factory's defense shutdown codes. You won't reach the President without me.
Cross the line, and I'll throw you back over it.
Seems fair enough.
Factory's big. I'll go on ahead and scout. Meet me at this position outside. There's a beacon there. Input this code, and I'll find you.
I can't be signed into power without a committee of Balmora citizens. Sir, if I find you a refuge, would you help me call them together?
Sure, Mr. Corden. You can count on me.
Be careful in there, both of you. Balmoran Arms is an Imperial stronghold, and Darth Lacris might be expecting you.
Stay quiet. It's a bad place to be hanging around. Activity spiked inside. Security changes, transport arrangements. Guess Darth Lacris is about to move the President.
There's no way I'll let her get away with it.
Passwords are all being changed. You'll need me to get to her.
I never get between a man and his obsession. See you at the ship.
Let's go, Jedi.
very subtle. Let me. President should be close by. Let's go.
Battlefield's the best teacher.
More meddling in my affairs. This is beyond tiresome, Zenith. I decreed that Balmoro would not become a forced labor world, and my reward? Your insolent little rebellion. Now this resistance government. You've given him delusions of grandeur, Jedi. But Balmoro is mine.
That man is mine.
Oh, precious. You actually think this fool president is of use to anyone? Even Thord, he can't help you. Your government is doomed. How sad.
Why couldn't the president help us?
You broke my apprentice just to learn at my feet. I'm touched.
No more talk! She has poisoned Balmora long enough.
I'm not without mercy. I'll grant you a swift death, rather than make you witness your plans tumbling down.
Happier to outlive someone. One death's too good for her. Troubling, though. What she said before about the president sounded too honest.
She's gone. Whatever plan she had are over.
Instincts for trouble keep me alive. I can get President Golthet back to the safe house, start his thaw. Meet me there. And be quick. Something's not right. Ty's gone to meet his Citizens Committee, coming to witness their new president's inauguration. Hooray for the Resistance. Darth Lacris got the last laugh. Meet our noble president.
Lonely. Gone. All. Who? No more. No. More.
Have you been hurt?
Hurt. Shame. Go. Go away.
Imperial torture shattered him. He can't hand over power. Lacris knew. No. The Empire can't win. We must fix this.
I know a technique that helps people driven mad by darkness.
Then try it.
Can't be. Go away.
Feared this. He's broken, not corrupted. Corporations donated medical technology. There's a spinal implant. Hacks into the brain and muscle functions. He'd speak properly. Sign his name. Experimental tech, though. Wouldn't last long, and it might kill him. But Ty will be in power, and I doubt the president would want to live like this.
I don't want Ty to become president because of a trick.
If Balmorans see President Galtha like this, after all we've suffered, they'll crack. Ty's presidency will fail. The end.
Ty escaped Imperial assassination for years. Ty himself proves there's hope.
If you're wrong, we lose everything. I hope you can handle that.
We heard about Darth Lacris. Citizens are already rising up in Sobrek. The occupation is ending. Sir, it's marvelous to see you again. My exile was too long.
Empty. All. Now. Go. Gone.
Ugh. Sir, it's Ty, your trade secretary. What's wrong with him?
His time as Darth Lacris's prisoner has left him little more than a shell.
No, this can't be. He's our leader.
Imperial atrocities. This is why we must never stop fighting against the Empire.
President Galtha is incapacitated. As senior official, Ty, you inherit his office.
I didn't want it to happen like this.
Ty Corden, we as fellow citizens of Balmora bear witness to your ascension to the office of president.
I pledge to carry out my duties with honesty, integrity, and compassion for Balmora.
Well done, President Corden. The Republic and the Jedi are with you.
As my first act, I've drafted a formal request for Balmora to join the Republic.
Is there anything you'd like to say on this historic occasion, Master Jedi?
You all stand on the threshold of a new beginning, for Balmora and for the Republic that waits to embrace you.
And I hope the Jedi Order will always be a part of that future. I have a few points of business to finish aboard your ship before I leave, Jedi. There's a matter we three need to discuss in private. Zenith, perhaps you should join us there.
A remarkable achievement. Balmora couldn't ask for a better leader. Here, Jedi, I'll authorize Ty's request for Republic membership.
Hey, Ty, you'd better get started on an heir. Presidents have heirs, right?
You know, Nadia, I'm really going to miss you.
Ty, Jedi got his reward. Balmora and the Republic. Mine? A seat in the new government, please.
I can't imagine you settling down to paperwork and election campaigning.
I have fresh ideas.
I'm sorry, Zenith. You've proved your loyalty, but I won't have you in my government. To truly free Balmora, we must purge the ideas the Empire forced on us. You've learned too much from them.
Any shadow of the dark side could doom Balmora before this rebirth has begun.
Jedi speak. Always useful.
I can compromise. I need a liaison between Balmora and the Rift Alliance, and a berth here just opened up. You'll have political pull and input on my decisions, just not on Balmora. Is that acceptable?
Jedi keeps a long view, makes tough choices. Might work.
You shoot anyone without my order, and there will be trouble.
Think the Rebellion's out of my system.
I've ordered thousands of new battle droids for the Republic. I'll stay in touch over Holo. Balmora is waiting. I, and my planet, will never forget what you both did. Thank you.
My apologies, everyone. Could you excuse us for a moment?
Jedi, I found something under our communications array. Look.
Nadia, I know you're new to space travel, but you can't go around pulling pieces off a starship.
It just came off in my hand. The Republic database says it's an Imperial monitoring device. Only someone on board would know where to plant it, right?
The Empire knows a communications array when it sees one.
Maybe, but I thought you should know. It deactivated itself when I picked it up, so it's safe now.
That isn't our only concern. I'd better keep this brief. What do you know of a world called Quesh?
Far too little, I'm afraid.
Quesh is a contested planet, simply overflowing with valuable chemicals. So the Rift Alliance built a research facility there, Attis Station. The station has developed amazing healing technology, some new weapons too. But they've dropped out of contact, and Imperial troops were sighted nearby. The others didn't want you to know.
I hoped I'd proven myself by helping Balmora.
Unfortunately, their "we've been neglected" attitude is hard to shake off. Attis Station houses the Rift Alliance's finest minds, and the technology and weapons they've developed mustn't fall into Imperial hands.
What was the situation before Attis Station went silent?
They sent a routine update, then we heard Imperial soldiers were in the area. Nothing more.
We'll find out when we arrive, won't we, Jedi?
We? Young lady, you are not setting foot on Quesh. It's far too dangerous.
But Father, Attis Station is built with our world's technology. If someone's using the defenses, I can get inside.
If anything happened to you, I'd never forgive myself.
You won't have to protect me. Promise. Just focus on saving the station and our scientists.
As you wish, Nadia. Apparently, responsibility is a lesson you don't need.
Then it's settled. Once you're on Quesh's surface, I'll catch up with you. If our station's even scratched, I'll teach those Imperials a lesson.